People like to complain about Libid Waiter apps often due to how changes in theming works, and you know what? I get it. But for me, it just doesn't really matter because of how many apps today are made in Electron. It would be one thing if everything was GTK and Qt and maybe now Iced as well. Getting that all being consistent is perfectly fine. Throw in web apps as well, and you have a complete disaster. But I don't want to talk about how theming works. Instead, I want to talk about issues with Libid Waiter apps that I don't really ever see anybody talking about. And I had to install a couple of them to make sure it wasn't just a one-off issue. And it seems like this is just consistent with how Libid Waiter stuff works. Now, the goal is not to pick on these two specific applications, they're just two fairly good examples. The one on the left is called Mission Center. This is basically a task manager clone. The one on the right is Boatswain. This is a tool to configure Elgato's Stream Deck. Now, the first issue is regarding my cursor size. Let's zoom in to make this even more clear. This is the size of my cursor. This is the size on every other application. Let's go over the Libid Waiter app. Suddenly, it grows in size. Let's go to the other one. And the exact same thing happens here as well. Zoomed out, it is less noticeable, but it's still something I'm going to notice every time it happens. This only happens with Libid Waiter applications. Let's open Alacrity. Cursor does not change size. Let's open Firefox, a GTK application. Cursor does not change size. Let's open a Qt6 application. And again, cursor does not change size. Only with the Libid Waiter applications does it grow in size. As I'm testing this on KDE, I thought maybe this was a KDE issue and doesn't affect anyone else. And that would make sense. Here is an issue opened 2 years ago of the exact same problem happening, but this time for someone using GNOME. Now, I assume that maybe it was because they were using Arch Linux, and Arch being a fairly clean distro, there's just certain things that are just not going to be set, and maybe there's a setting somewhere that you need to make sure is being set. But someone affected in here a month ago was on Silverblue. At some point, people were having luck setting their X cursor size to 24, which is the default size of the cursor, but it didn't seem like it was working for everyone, and some people had to make sure they weren't using the Breeze cursor, instead they were using the Edwita cursor. As you can see, I'm clearly not using the Breeze cursor, and on these applications here, I'm not using the Breeze cursor, so that doesn't seem to be what it is either. I don't know how to fix this. Now, the second problem is related to theming, but theming for a practical purpose. I don't run the standard Plasma Breeze decorations. Instead, I use decorations called Classy. What these let me do are nice things like having a colored border around my windows, having different icons in the little icon thingy here that I prefer the look of over the default ones that Breeze ship. Now, if I go and hover over this window, no border, this window, no border, this window, border, only Libid Waiter applications, and I guess other things that use client-side decorations, ignore the border, and ignore the icons that I'm setting because they're doing their own set of icons. Why do I care about the border? Well, this is a visual indicator of which window I currently have focused. And you might think, oh, that's stupid. Like, why would you want to do that? Well, I like using this thing that automatically hides my cursor after a set amount of time or if I start typing. And sometimes it can be easy to forget which window you currently have focused. And when I was testing out things like Polonium and Cronkite, a standard way to handle having it tiling is having a visual indicator around the window that indicates where your focus currently lies. It makes it very easy for doing things like using keyboard shortcuts to move around windows to change your focus and other things like that. It is something I'm just used to having and really feels weird when it is not there. Now, I can deal with it not being there. The problem I have is when it is there on some windows. But here's the amusing thing. This is a very inconsistent issue. This happens on KDE because KDE respects an application that wants to do client-side decorations and wants to do things the way they want to do it. But if we're talking about something like Sway, for example, it's just gonna go and put borders around the windows, and it does not care the way the application wants to be rendered. Now, in KDE, there are supposed to be window rules and overrides for dealing with client-side decorations and making decorations actually render properly. I've personally not had any luck using them. I've messed around with them for like 20, 30 minutes, and it doesn't seem to be making any effect whatsoever. I don't know if I'm doing something wrong or there's something else going on there. So I thought after the fact, why don't I test it with a CSD application that isn't LibidWaiter? Steam. So let's go and detect the properties, grab the window class, add the property down here, no title frame and bar, set this to no, apply now, apply. And that seems to work. It didn't work when I tried it on the LibidWaiter stuff though. But let's just assume they were working perfectly fine. I just don't want to have to deal with that for every time I run across a new LibidWaiter application. I just want things to, at a bare minimum, use my window decorations properly. And here's a problem that is mostly ignorable, but is still really annoying because I don't want to deal with it. So let's move to the edge of this Alacrity window. Look at that, a handle to grab the side. Let's go to the bottom, handle here, to the corner, handle here, so on and so forth. We've all seen a handle when we get to the edge of a window. Let's do it with the LibidWaiter application. Go right here. And nothing is appearing. Let's go to this one. Nothing is appearing. Let's go to the side here. Nothing. And nothing. Now, to be fair, I think this one might be more of an issue with KDE as opposed to LibidWaiter. So I think the way that it determines which icon to be using is by using the border that is being rendered from your decorations. But we don't have the border from our decorations being used here, so it can't grab onto that point. Now, the fun thing here is we can still resize the window. If I grab this point here, it is gonna swap. If I grab this point here, it's gonna swap. This point here, so on and so forth. So the function is still working, but the visual change upon hover only seems to work if the decoration is there. During editing, I decided to go and test this with Steam, and it seems like my theory is mostly kinda correct. So you might notice it is changing to the icon on a very, very small point sometimes. It's very inconsistent. Right at that point there and nowhere else, but only so- oh, it's moved that time. It definitely seems like KDE does really weird things if borders are not present. Now, by not rendering the icon, it can be a little bit annoying to work out exactly where the point you can resize is. Now, because the cursor changes size, it's actually a little bit easier than it otherwise would be. So, look, maybe the cursor resize actually is a beneficial feature in this very, very specific circumstance. But the other reason that you can ignore this is if you hold down super and then right click on a window, it's one of the desktops where you can do super right click resizing. So you never actually have to interact with the real corner anyway. And I don't know about you guys, but this is the way that I usually handle windows. There are absolutely great LibidWaiter applications. Boatswain is a great example. But unless it's something like Boatswain, where there just simply is not another option available, at least another option to the same level, I think if you do have choices, especially if you're a KDE user, I would highly recommend using anything besides the LibidWaiter application. If at some point all of these issues just get resolved and are no longer an issue, yes, the theming stuff is still there, but much like with running Discord, I can deal with the theme being wrong. I don't want to deal with these things that clearly are just bugs. Now, I have separate issues with GNOME design language that just make applications more annoying to use for the sake of visuals, like the obsession with hamburger menus where they just don't need to be there. There is a time and a place for a hamburger menu. That time and place is usually on a website. It doesn't need to be there for 3 buttons. There is a better way to handle this. Just have the buttons right here. Why do I need to click to see that? Why do I need a quit button when there's a quit button right there? Like, I just don't get it. But that's a whole separate issue. So due to the issues pointed out here, along with the general theming issue you've heard countless other people talk about, I do certainly think there is a place for discussions like this. Please don't use the libedwaiter library. Now, that doesn't mean go and harass developers who want to use libedwaiter. Don't go and do that. But if they are questioning, should we use it, shouldn't we use it, what is the upgrade, what is the downgrade, does this make sense to fit with the project? If they are trying to be something that fits well into the GNOME desktop, and that is their goal, go ahead, use libedwaiter. But keep in mind, if you want to work well on other desktops, especially the second biggest, KDE, going down the libedwaiter route, you are going to see some unexpected problems that most people don't talk about. And honestly, I wish they did, because the theming stuff is so overdone, and if you use Discord, like, you already knew things weren't going to be consistent anyway, and if you have a terminal, it's probably not going to be consistent, and there's so many things in your system that just aren't consistent anyway. Having one more thing that isn't consistent, yeah, it's a pretty big thing, but it's just one more thing to add to the list. But what do you think? Do you run libedwaiter applications outside of GNOME? And if you are on GNOME, have you seen any of these issues happen on your desktop? Or are some of these just my system specific? Because I've noticed some of those do tend to exist with certain things. I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to Liberopay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and make code. What is this?